Keith. Hi, Keith. Do you think you could come in here for a minute? My fax seems to be jammed.
Sure, let's take a look.
Hey, Magpie. What's going on? Nothing. What's going on with you?
Are you sure? Because I'm pretty sure you just caught a glimpse of your own brain with how far your eyes went back.
No, I had something in my eye.
That's the worst. It's always fuzz, which is like near impossible to see. Do you want me to blow in it for you?
What?
Your eye. Do you want me to blow in your eye to get the fuzz out?
Thank you, Todd. I'm okay, though.
Alright, well don't forget, I'm right over here if you need me.
I tell ya, Keith really knows how to use his hands. What? I wouldn't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, he just knows how to turn me on.
I think you mean your fax. I fixed your fax.
Oh yeah, that too. We need to talk.
Mm-hmm.
Listen, I can't do this anymore. This job is really important to me, and it's already affecting my relationships with everyone.
Maggie, come on. It's only been a week. They're way too self-involved to see that you and I love each other. They don't have the capacity to see what true love is.
See? That. I can't take this right now. We've only been dating for a week, and already you're talking about love? I need to stay focused. I've been shining Mr. Feldman's shoes for far too long to let anything distract me now. He expects me to be his lifeline to the whole office, and if I let anything get in the way of my relationships with everyone, there's no chance that I'm gonna be his right-hand man, woman, whatever he needs right now.
Maggie, please, we can't-
I can't seem to find my underwear. Have either of you seen it? What's got her panties in a bunch? Oh, there they are. Wait a minute. These are from last week.
Maggie, can you come in here for a minute?
Yes, sir, I'll be right in.
What are they doing out there?
I believe Todd is still searching for an appropriate workplace prank.
Yeah, I'm still trying to get the smell out of here from his last trial and error.
He's such a sweet kid. He'll figure out what kind of person he is in the office sooner or later.
It better be sooner rather than later.
I'm trying, I promise.
I know you are. You're the only one I can really count on around here. It's not really why I called you in here. You're a good person, right?
I definitely try to be.
My wife told me she's gonna leave me if I don't start softening up a little bit and stop focusing on the bottom line. Her shrink suggested that I volunteer somewhere. I suggested that I donate a lump sum to a charity. He said that's not really the point.
Okay, Mr. Feldman, where do you think you'll volunteer?
I was hoping you'd figure that out for me. You do charity work. Where do you volunteer?
I go to the soup kitchen after work on Wednesdays. Tuesday and Thursday before work, I go to the orphanage. On Sundays, I'm at the animal shelter.
Okay.
Oh, and Saturdays, I'm at the elderly home down on 5th.
Wow. Okay. Well, where do you think I'd fit?
Oh, anywhere, Mr. Feldman. They'd all be happy to have you.
Well, today's Wednesday. Why don't I go down to the soup kitchen for you for about half an hour?
They really ask that you put in at least an hour.
Okay. I can swing that. For the hungry, what's an hour of my time?
Okay. Oh, Mr. Feldman, I think you're gonna love it. I'm really sorry, Mr. Feldman. I didn't think they'd know who you were and hate you so much for it.
I give my time, which is very valuable. Time is money, Maggie, and I'm worth millions.
Yes, of course, Mr. Feldman.
I'm going home to my wife and I'm calling my lawyer. I don't need her. I'll have another wife within a month.
Poor guy. Stop right there. Listen here, little boy. If you want to get freaky with me, that's not the way to go. You have got to lay off these pranks. They're annoying and so unfunny. They're just mean.
Yeah? Well, at least I'm not throwing my gooch at every male body that passes and getting rejected.
I'm not.
Yeah, lady. You're old and dried up and nobody wants you.
Maggie.
Are you gonna say anything, or are we just gonna keep reminding each other that we know the other's name?
I'm lovesick.
Well, I'm just sick. I think I caught something at the soup kitchen last week, and Mr. Feldman has it too. See?
I don't think you're sick. I think we're feeling...
Under the weather, Keith. I think we all need to go home and get a good night's rest.
So much to believe in, we were lost in time.
This is a prank.
Wow, she's incredible.